Hey guys, Chris Egnoto here. And you need to know, this is a threatening species. This is the one you've got to watch out for. So I figured I'll make a video on it. So bear with me. So over the past two or three decades, the tiger mosquito has spread to many countries, mostly due to agriculture and produce, and also the tourist industry. Now the adults will feed on nectar. The females will only feed on blood when it's time for them to make eggs. They need that protein. You can identify the tiger mosquito due to its black and white striped legs and also the black and white striped body. Now there's our regular type of mosquito. And the reason why mosquitoes feed on our blood, or mammal blood, is because they use that blood to manufacture their eggs. Okay, without that blood, they can't make their eggs. And then, as you know, they need water to lay their eggs in. I don't really enjoy doing this. I'm doing it for the sake of YouTube, but it's very uncomfortable. But this is our native species. This is the species that I'm used to, which is why I'm not reacting to it too much right now. They pretty much always keep their legs up in the air like that when they're feeding. I'm not sure why.
So there you go. I just got tagged by two of the mosquitoes immediately. It's like that. So you can imagine how bad it is when I get a bunch of them. That's the tiger mosquito. That's what it does to me.
Okay guys, now let me just assure you, I'm not a big fan of being bit by mosquitoes. I really wanted to make a video on the tiger mosquito because they are really pretty looking, aren't they? But please bear in mind, they are vectors of numerous diseases and viruses. They can carry dengue fever, they can vector yellow fever, even nematodes and the Zika virus and things like that. So I'm only doing this, you know, carefully. I'm in a suburban area. It's less likely for me to contract any of those diseases from them. If you're in a highly populated area, you have more of a chance of contracting these diseases. But also, the tiger mosquito is fairly different from your normal mosquito. They're not exactly closely associated with wetland environments like the other mosquitoes we're used to are. These mosquitoes can just find a little puddle and some leaves, or a puddle in your gutter or something like that, and reproduce and breed right there. Okay, so they're found in most environments right now. And they'll bite during the day, they'll bite during the rain, you know, sunshine, wind, doesn't matter. So it's a tough mosquito. Okay, so let's get back to video, guys.
And there you go, that's what mosquito larvae look like. Okay, so when you see these things in little puddles of water on your property, you might want to dump the water or do something to treat it. There are things you can put in the water that like to eat mosquito larvae, if you want to take that route.
This is a perfect example of a breeding ground for mosquitoes. Anything can hold a puddle of water in it. A gutter like this, maybe a car tire, an empty container sitting in the backyard, a tarp, anything. So please check your property for things like this and try to remove them. Most mosquitoes are not found any further than 90 feet from a water source. Chris Egnoto, signing out.
Great. I didn't mean to feed that mosquito and then let it